convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height or depth, nor anything else in creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Hello, gifted podcast listener. You are loved by the biggest force on earth. We are very excited to have you on this platform. The purpose of this podcast is to bring God's word to encourage you and help you to overcome. We encourage you to spread the word to family and friends by sharing the audio or the video clip on your social media platforms. Invite your friends to join the group as well. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get into the word with Pastor Kwame. God bless you. I am Stephanie, and I will catch up with y'all later.
Who is like unto thee, O God, who is like unto thee? Among the gods, there is no one like you. Fearful in holiness, fearful in praise, doing wonders, hallelujah. We want to honor your name and bless you because you are good. There is no one like you. We come to worship you. We come to bless you. We come to honor you. We come to say that there is no one beside you. On this Monday, we submit our lives to you. When you are with us, it doesn't matter what day it is. We know that because you are alive, we will also live. May your name be glorified in our lives. In Jesus' name. I want to greet you in the invincible name of our Lord Jesus Christ, child of God. I want to believe that you are doing well and your family. Greetings from my family to your family. May the Lord continue to be nice to you. Amen. All right. I'm reading from the book of Exodus. Praise God. The book of Exodus. In the book of Exodus, chapter 13, the verse number 19. The Bible says now, God will certainly come to help you. When he does, you must take my bones with you from this place. God will certainly come to help you. When he does, you must take my bones with you from this place. This is Joseph obviously talking. I want to talk about the price of certainty. The price of certainty. The price tag of certainty. It's going to be a lot of short stories to frame the message, but let me start with this. You've heard Apostle Paul say something like, "I know whom I have believed." It's a very interesting phrase, because within the same phrase we see knowing and believing, and sometimes we only believe because we don't know. But Paul says, "I know whom I have believed." So hold that thought. I'll come back to that. There's another verse that is very popular in the scripture, which is, "For lack of knowledge, my people perish." Now, the application of that verse is what we use most of the time, but a lot of people don't know the meaning of the verse. When you apply "for lack of knowledge, my people perish," it's applicable in every situation. Applicable in knowledge about your car, applicable about knowledge about your marriage, applicable in every area. But that is not what the Bible is saying. The Bible is not saying "for lack of knowledge." It says "for lack of the knowledge of God." That's what the verse is saying. "For the lack of the knowledge of God, my people perish." And so your value is measured by your knowledge of God. Your value is measured by your knowledge of God. Do you understand that? And the knowledge of God comes from the journey of uncertainty to certainty. Now, let me not confuse you with all of these words. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that for you to know God, you must move from "I don't know" to "I know." The verse we read is Joseph saying, "I know of a certainty that God will come and take you out." How did he know? Because he's speaking from a journey of uncertainty to certainty. He's speaking from a boy who was put in prison. He's speaking from a boy who was put in the pit. He's speaking from a boy who, once upon a time, was not sure if God was going to be God for him. But at the end of the day, when God became God for him, he speaks with certainty. He doesn't say, "I believe God will come for you." He says, "I know, because I have journeyed from uncertainty to certainty. And that journey is expensive. And that's what I want to talk to you about. The journey from uncertainty to certainty is an expensive journey. And sometimes it's difficult to go that journey. But I want to talk to you about how to go that journey. Because that is, at the same time, you see, it's as simple as ABC. How expensive you dress is how expensive you are. You got it? How expensive your dress is how expensive you are. So how expensive your journey from uncertainty to certainty is how expensive you are. And that's how God measures your value, by how much you know Him. All right. So what we're going to talk about today, therefore, is that for you to come to a place where you are expensive, to be an expensive person means that you know God at a level that somebody doesn't know. It comes down, therefore, to the same thing Paul said, I know whom I believe. And that journey, it costs a lot. So a lot of people never become expensive people. I want to break it down simply to you that it takes problems to know God. It takes problems to know God. And so when you run away from your problems, you are run away from the knowledge of God. And it is through the problems that you gain knowledge, and therefore you become expensive. Now let me go to my area of study. Let me brag a little bit. I'm a chemist, but I don't know much. I'm a chemist, and in that field of study, we don't call it knowledge of God. We call it from research and development to production. Do you understand that? From I don't know what this is to I know what this is. That journey is called from research and development to production. So it costs a lot of money for us to take a drug that we don't know, take whatever we don't know, and test it and keep doing so many things to it. For us to gain the full knowledge of it and know what it does. And once you get the knowledge of this medicine, get the knowledge of this material, get the knowledge of it, through research and development, through a lot of expensive experiments and a lot of processes you put it through, then you begin to gain the full knowledge of it. And now you can take that knowledge and now sell it to people. And so that journey is how you increase the value of the product. Are you following? All right. So with all of that said, you and I are going to be valuable people before God and before men if we understand what it takes to be valuable, which is the price you pay. And that price is the problems that are being set up in your life. Are you following me? Joseph said, certainly God will come and take you out, because I know it. I know it because I know. Trust me, I know. His years of research and development has shown him that God takes people out. Doesn't matter how long it takes. But you don't know that. For you to come to that knowing, that certainty, you have to have problems. You have to have delays. You have to have challenges. You have to have issues that you are battling with. But I want you to see those issues as your value in life. Your problems are your value. Your problems are not designed to depreciate you, but to appreciate you. The challenges you face in life are specifically handpicked by God to give you value. Because when you have those problems, you can say definitively, I know God will do this. Why? Because if He did it before, He could do it again. So you are... It doesn't cost anything to be uncertain. Do you know what will happen? I don't know. Nobody, you don't have to pay for anything. I don't know is the cheapest answer in town. You don't have to pay for it. I don't know is easy. But I know comes with some experience. All right, so let's begin to get into that. And I'll share with you on the cost of uncertainty. The first thing is that the cost of certainty. The first thing is the topic. Certainty cost something. To know God, it will cost you. To know God, it will cost you. And what is the price? To know God, you will have to accept problems as is. Amen. To know God, you have to accept problems as is. Some of you are going through problems, but you don't want to accept the problems. You know, you are trying so hard to make the problem disappear by finding quick answers that are not from God. I came to cut you some slack and to tell you it's okay if you don't know when you're going to get married. It's okay if you don't know when you're going to get well. It's okay if you don't know when things are going to get better. That is because the uncertainty will be there until the certainty comes. So you will live in this tension of not knowing what is next, and then walk by faith to the point, oh God help me. The whole thing is, you are going to come to a place where you'll be part of the I don't know. And it's never going to be over, because you're always going to move from uncertainty to certainty. But you got to stay there. Do you understand that? Number two, don't be afraid of your problems. Goliath is a problem. Goliath is a problem. But if you're afraid of Goliath, you will not be lifted. Do you understand? One of the things I like about being the second or the third to come to do anything is that you get to have past questings. You understand? Past questions. If you are the first batch, there's no past questions. But if you are the fourth, fifth batch, there's past questions that can help you prepare. And we have past questions. The whole Old Testament is a past questions. So you should understand that if God did it for Sarah, he can do it for me. If God did it for Joseph, he can do it for me. So with that, you stay in and you wait for your life to upgrade from uncertainty to certainty. Praise the Lord. So don't feel again that you should or by all means know all things. But your value will increase as you hold on to what you don't know and trust God to know it. And number two, running away from your problems in life, running away, trying to find quick fixes, trying to cut corners is not how you increase in value. Hallelujah. Whatever you are going through, go through it. It will make you an expensive person. Whatever life has given you, go through it and you will start saying, I know that my daughter will not die. I know that my sister will not die. I know. How do you know? Because I've paid for it. I have paid the knowledge I'm speaking, I have paid for it. Hallelujah. And that is what I want to share with you today. That the cost of certainty is the problems of your life. And once you stay put, once you stay consistent, once you stay confident in whom you have believed. And I just want to say, let me pause and can we talk a little bit? The thing is, what I'm preaching is only good on the graduation day. But let me talk about before the graduation day, when you are dealing with uncertainty. I'm telling you, you become suicidal sometimes. You become hopeless sometimes. You try to call Hagar sometimes. You fall sometimes. You stug sometimes. Because it is expensive. Some of you, when things get that difficult, you don't backslide, but you take a you take a quick something and come back in. Because the price to come to I know is not an easy walk. You go on bad dates, some bad dates sometimes. You throw yourself into workaholicism sometimes. You just work so you don't have to deal with the miserable life you have. And all kinds of secret supporting lifestyles becomes our diet to go through the dry seasons of your life until gradually you come to I know. The emotional price tag. The guy who said I know, let's talk about him a little bit and then we'll close. Joseph said, I know God will come and get you out of here. Because if I count my life, and when I look at the life of Joseph, maybe I'll use that to finish up. The crazy thing about our lives is that we don't know how tomorrow will turn out. And so when you are in a problem, there's no guarantee that you will come out of it. And sometimes when it's taking so long, you don't know, have a reference point. You have not seen your tomorrow before. So how do you know that you know that you know? You just got to weather the storm and wait on that faithfulness of God, which is like the second coming of Christ. Whether it's today or tomorrow, nobody knows. Amen. So Joseph sat in the pit. And you know something? There are sometimes the things you go through, I don't think you really know what you're going through. God blinds you to how difficult your life is sometimes. Because once you look back, you're surprised how you were able to survive that. What mentor, what are you going to think about when your brothers have put you in a pit? How do you process that? And how do you process being sold into slavery? The Ishmaelites who were going somewhere. How do you process all of that? How do you process a boy who is loved by the father, who is stripped from the father, placed in the pit, thrown to some strangers who are going to merchandise him, find out in a strange land? I have a joke. Can I share my joke with you? Am I supposed to joke at this time of the podcast when I'm supposed to be in the spirit? When I came to America from Africa, which is about 20 years ago, it took me 3 years before I came to America. I came to America, but it took me 3 years before I came to America. Let me explain. When I landed here, my soul was still in Africa because all the dreams I had, there was no America in it. That is how long it took me for my whole three-piece, the spirit, soul, and body to come to America. My body came, but my soul was still in Africa. It takes a lot to transition. So to take Joseph and me, I'm coming to my parents. Even that, it took me 3 years for me to really get all my faculties in one place. For 3 years, I never had any dream that America was in. All my dreams were about Ghana, because that was what I shaped the 18-year-old boy that I was. So Joseph has been taken away and placed in a strange place, going through all of that, and then ended up put in prison for doing the right thing. Take that for a price tag. Some of you are in prison, not literally, but in some challenges, because you did the wrong thing. And even that one, you want to blame God. How about the boy who did the right thing and ended up in jail? So when he says, I know, you better listen to me. The boy is valuable. He knows what he's talking about. I pray that in the name of Jesus, you will know what you are talking about, because you will come to the place of certainty. And he stays in prison. He doesn't know where his life is going. You know, some of you have gone to the Potiphar's house and life has kicked you back into the prison. I have a word for you. You are closer than you think. You almost got engaged and it didn't work out. You are closer than you think. At the end of the day, all you are going through is going to bring you to a place of value. Let's pray because of time. Father, we thank you for your wisdom that is above all wisdom. Thank you for your will that is above all wills. We are ready to go with you until our value increases in you. In Jesus' name, amen.